heavy rainstorm occurs, hundreds of gallons of water are wasted down the drain. Literally. The water flows off the impermeable surfaces that our society has constructed. An impermeable surface is any surface that cannot absorb the water and therefore is directed into other outlets, like storm drains, sewage systems, rivers, and other bodies of water. The problem with this is that when a heavy rainfall occurs, there's a large rush into the waterways, and that can overwhelm the water systems and possibly cause flooding.
So how can we prevent this loss of water? Buy a rain barrel!
What is a rain barrel? Well, a rain barrel sits at the bottom of a gutter and intercepts the water from the gutter where it would have been directed into the storm drain. The water will collect and flow into the barrel to where you can save it for later use, like watering plants. This will avoid having water sitting around the gutter. The puddles that would have been there are a big welcome sign to mosquitoes and other pests. You can purchase these barrels online. However, one of their uses are to carry food and store food. I saw one carrying olives. Chances are, if you ask nicely, a restaurant might let you use theirs.
In the direction of finances, rain barrels could save money. In a 1-inch rainstorm, 700 gallons of water could be produced. This is enough to fill several rain barrels, whose water could be used to wash cars or water plants. These activities could save up to 40% on the average water bill. Using the water collected from a barrel, you could save some of that money. With the standing puddles sitting at the bottom of the gutters around buildings, this could cause erosion, resulting in thousands of dollars worth of damage.
What?
Not to mention the amount of mold formed when the water seeps into your basement.
To educate people about rain barrels, we need to put up flyers around campus and pass out pamphlets. We can also bring in speakers to tell the college community about the importance of rain barrels and how Mercyhurst can benefit from having rain barrels around its campus.
One of the biggest questions is, where would we put these rain barrels? Well, here outside of Weber Hall, we have some gutters that don't have anything on the bottom. So basically, the rain just drips out of these onto the sidewalk. If we put rain barrels here, we could save this rainwater and use it for watering plants or other uses around campus.
Here outside of Ward Hall, water builds up on the ground. In order to prevent this, we can put a rain barrel here, and then we can reuse this water.
So, Julie, how do we make a rain barrel?
I don't know, Sarah. Let's find out.
Insert the bit into the center of the plug, hold down tightly, and start this off. What we're going to do is we're going to turn the barrel on its side. We're going to take our tape measure and we're going to measure up 2.5 inches up on the barrel. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to line that drill bit up right on that hole. Once we do that, we're going to cut. We're going to go ahead and we're going to insert the bung. Pull out with one hand, twist with the other. Do so until you get the bung tight. So now that the bung's in place, we're gonna go ahead and install our valve. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our window screen, we're gonna cut a section. What we want to do is make a section about 6 by 6 inches. Take that 6 by 6 inch screen, place it over the adapter, and put the clamp into place. We can go ahead and put it in our first hole that we drilled.
Well, thank you, James Lacker from YouTube.
So now what do we do?
We decorate! One of the ways to get students involved is to have a rain barrel art contest, where students can win a prize for the best design. In order to do this, we would need to have waterproof paint, and we would need to make sure that the rain barrels can withstand the elements.